Então, para quais são as vantagens das bolsas? Depois I want to say for organizers, I am very grateful to participate in this conference, and in my talk I will discuss some point of view, very simple object, a scalar equation, quadratic equation. How at first I will say something about standard generalized symmetries like space or quadratic equations. And then I present one of quadratic equations with very non-standard properties and discuss its like space, discuss recursion and massive symmetry. Then I present some other similar examples. At first in non-autonomous case and some and one autonomous example of the same type. So to say about standard properties, I want to discuss не работает ключ.
Работал.
It was switched off. To discuss properties of quadratic equations, I show how quadratic equation can appear. So one way to appear quadratic equation is discretization preserving integrals. For example, if we consider Liouville equations, it's known that Liouville equation has true integrals in different directions. This is y integrals and this is x integral. These integrals satisfy to these equations. And what we want to find? We want to find semidiscrete equation. So we just design one variable y, go from y to discrete variable n, and want that this integral is preserved in this case. So we want that this function I will be n integral. N integral must satisfy to this equation. Shifted the function that is the remain same. If we put this function to this equation, we get this relation. Here we see that t x6 is independent variables. So this must be equal to this, to the unity. So we can start to define function f in this way. And continuing in this way, we can find this semidiscrete equation. So I will in some times omit index n for more closer notation, shorter notation. And after this first step, we want to discretize variable x in the same way. You find that equation free admits x integral f such that total derivative of x from f is equal to 0. And this quote integral is equal to this function. So if we differentiate this function with respect to x and use this equation e, we will get 0. And now we look for quadratic discrete equation in this polynomial, and equation that function f is its m integral. So m integral satisfies to this equation. And in this step, we again can solve this problem and find discrete equation in this polynomial. So this is quad equation. It's like quad integrable quad equation. And this quad equation has two integrals. This integral in M direction and this integral in N direction. So function of V and function T are here in the current M directions. And this way of discretization is very useful. For example, using this method, we were able to find discrete version of exponentially hyperbolic type systems. If here A is a Cartan matrix responding to the algebra, then in this article, authors found semi discrete version of exponentially hyperbolic type system. And in this article, we find full discrete version of exponentially hyperbolic type systems. Here in the left hand side, one can see mixed differential. So the limit of this function is mixed difference, and here we see that if we at limit it tends to this exponent. So in a recent paper of Sergey Smirnov, he described a semi-discrete version of hyperbolic exponential system in a sense that if this system have full set of integrals, then this system will have also the same full set of integrals. And now we see that this quad equation is very similar logic to hyperbolic type equations, and so they both have very similar properties. For example, they have like sphere in this problem. In discrete case, this problem in continuous case, and the two possibilities depending on the type of symmetries. First one for equations of sine Bogdan type. In this case, in continuous equations, symmetries depends on such derivative. The derivative is type. In discrete case, symmetries is equations of Poincaré type. And A and B in this case is two by two matrices dependent on the dynamical variables and spectral parameters. The second one possibility is a Zeta type equation. The Zeta type equation has a symmetry which depends on its order derivatives in and continual case, and in case of quad equation, the Zeta type equation have a symmetry which depends from n plus 2 to n minus 2 in n direction, and from n plus 2 to n minus 2 in n direction. And in this case, A and B are free by three matrices depend on dynamical variables. And for a long time,
what is A and B in the previous slide?
Matrices of common and for a long time, all integrable nonlinear equation here for one of these structure. And I think in continuous case, the situation remains the same. But in this slide, I show that comparing to disk and hyperbolic equation by examples. Here, real type equation. Here, sine cosine type equation. And here, Tsatsik type equation. For what equation? One equation of Tsatsik type equation is fine in article of Mikhailov and CNTs. And what about what graph equation with unusual properties? This equation we find in this article. We make some classification work for first order type symmetries. I say first order because it's dependent on one shift to positive direction and one shift for negative direction. And we find this equation. This equation has one symmetry. I say one, but as one, I say the lowest order symmetry. And if this equation has a only hierarchical symmetries, but I show the lowest order symmetry. And one, it's mean only in M direction, not in M direction. So in M direction, we found this generalized symmetry. It's a first order type. And if we look for symmetry in M direction, then we see that two necessary integrability condition is satisfied. So we can start to find the right hand side of this symmetry in this volume. But we cannot find this symmetry because it's not exist. So at first it was confusing how it's happened. One symmetry exists, but the second symmetry is almost exist, but not exist. But then we try to find the symmetry of second order, and we were successful. And we find not one symmetry, we find two symmetry of second order. One can see here that this symmetry depends the two shift to positive direction and two shift to negative direction. And it contains a function of discrete variable n, a, n, and this function has a period 2. So this function can be written as a sum of constant and sum of some constant multiplied to minus one of power n. So it's contained two cases. One case is autonomous and one non-autonomous case. And these two cases generate all other possible subcases as linear combination. And from some point of view, this example is unique up to these days. So later I will show some very similar examples. And now I want to discuss this example in more details. At first, you find Lux pair for these examples. Lux pair is found in Julian article with Mikhailov and Emilov. And for constructing this LAP, we use the fact that the symmetry in N direction is equivalent to some known system of two equations. This system looks like this, and this system is nothing else than a system of weak point switching from the adjunct of switching. And this system is impeccable discretization is one of derivative non-linear Schrodinger equation. And it's related to our symmetry in integration by this substitution. We see that n is equal to k. So if we shift the variable k, then it's related to two times shift of variable n. So we put for even values of O variable k, for odd values of O W, for function A in point to k alpha, and for function A in point to k minus one beta, and then one-to-one correspondence between system 11 and equation 8. For Suchida system, like Sperry, is a usual forum. There's a usual forum. Gk is a shift operator in k direction. D, T1 is a full derivative with respect to T1. And we use this substitution and we write this log Sperry in n variable. And what we see in this case, the log Sperry become unstandard because it contains not one shift in the integration, it contains twice shift in the integration. But if as equation of sine Bogdan type is written in 2 by 2 matrices, but contain twice shift in integration. We can rewrite it by using one shift in integration, but in this case, we will need to go to 4 by 4 matrices with block structure. And this log Sperry is equivalent to equation of H. For operators which define M shift and derivative with respect to T2, the matrices presented in this slide, and compatibility conditions for discrete equation look like this. And this compatibility condition is equivalent to what equation 6. So log Sperry is also non-standard because it contains two shift by two, not for one. And for construct periodic for symmetries in n and m direction, we use matrix symmetry in n direction and construct perturbation operators in n direction. For matrix symmetry in n direction, we use the fact that the symmetry in n direction is equivalent to this known system of Terry type. And for this equation, the matrix symmetry can be constructed as shown in article of Adler, Shabbat, and Miller. For those, we need to introduce time of matrix symmetry into the equation of with respect to G2. And this is a standard way. It can be done in this by this formula. And then matrix symmetry is made by this formula. And by simple my multiplier for discrete variable thing. And this equation, if you put tau equal to zero, coincide with tau symmetry in n direction. And by using this matrix symmetry 22, you can construct full hierarchy of symmetries in a standard way. For example, the next order symmetry is equal, is equal to this equation. And this is the symmetry for this equation true. The recursion operator in any direction constructing standard program is a combination of Hamiltonian operator and symplectic operator. For found these operators, we used the article of anxiety, Mikhailov and Pang, and they present these operators for suited system, and we regard these operators for scalar equation. In this case, the symplectic operator look like this. It's a local, and Hamiltonian operator look like this. It's a local, it's a, have this a local chunks, and moreover, it has a true periodic function, true periodic arbitrary function Cn. So we can see that not one hyperbolic operator, Hamiltonian operator, but two Hamiltonian operators, because this true periodic function contain two constants, two arbitrary constants. And here the formulas for which satisfy symplectic and Hamiltonian operators, all these formulas are standard. And by using these recursion operators, we can construct hierarchies of generalized symmetries in any directions. The next symmetry look like this. Here the second term contains the second order symmetry, because the sum of this function is equal to constant, and this is correspond to point symmetry. And this term is for order generalized type symmetry. It's again contain arbitrary triperiodic function. So in this way, we can construct even order generalized symmetries, and probably the order generalized symmetry doesn't exist in this case. And in even order exists true generalized symmetries. And this situation is very unusual for scalar intuition. From the viewpoints systems like Tuchida or relativistic total type equation, this situation is usual. And we can show a relation between our symmetry in any direction and relativistic product chain. To do this, we can see that in this situation of constant of Tsuchida system, in this situation, if we check this variable or this variable, then in any of these four cases, we can combine any of this and any of this. We get the same equation for function O capital. And this equation is nothing else but relative sum of relativistic total type equation. It looks like this. So we can say that our discrete equation 6 is Bethlen transformation, is Bethlen transformation for this equation in some sense. But you need to remember that here shift of variable k, and in this equation we have a shift of variable n, and n and k is connected such k is equal to shift of n twice. And if we
can show on second question number six.
Six.
Which one is it?
Fix this. So instead of n, I need to put 2k. And what we can do else from this symmetry edge, and we can obtain some hyperbolic calculation. To do this, let us consider two examples of this equation edge. Here I omit index n because it's a non-sufficient here. So I consider only variables in n direction. And here I use this function c here. And this function c is equal to 1 in even point and equal 0 in odd point. So this equation for any point n depends not on 5 shifts, it depends on 4 shifts. And the one equation in x direction and second equation in y direction. Both these equations have a lax representation. One of them with matrices A with index 1, the second one with index 2. In first one, I replace the function AN by EN. In second one, I replace function AN by EN minus 1. And what I can do is I can replace a double shift of function O by this derivative and only one shift. And this is these formulas can be obtained from system 32. Because if I multiply this equation by key function, I can see I multiply key function to key function with shift is equal to zero. Because key function something like as a projective function. And after this representation, I can change by variable t this function o by variable o this and by r this. And then I obtain this 2 by 2 matrices. And from the compatibility condition, we get this system of hyperbolic calculation. This system is integrable as it's as LXPair. But moreover, you can obtain 2 plus 1 dimensional lattice equation similar to 2 dimensional total lattice by computing these 2 equations. Because statistically, 2 equation is commute, and we can find the mixed derivative of U and replace some shifted variables, shifted derivatives, and get this 2 plus 1 dimensional lattice equation. Is this equation integrable or not? The questions remain open. But what we can say? We can say that any common solution of this system 32 is a solution of this 2 plus 1 dimensional lattice equation. So it must be integrable, but if it's integrable or not, it's a question. And now I want to show some similar examples. One series of examples of such type can be found in non-autonomous part equation. To show this, we can consider that first H1 equation from Adler Pavenko Solis list. This is the simplest representation of the list. And in autonomous case, it's a discrete potential TV equation. And the second example is completely discrete analog of Poisson-Gressen chain. In non-autonomous case, it's has been introduced in article of Levy and Miller. In the autonomous case, for constant alpha n, it can be found in the article of Hirota Tsujimoto or in the same article of Nathan Kepler. What we can say about these equations? Both these equations have a standard Lux pair. For first equation Lux pair look like this. For the second equation Lux pair look like this. And for discrete chain, the first order symmetry in M direction exists. But you can say that for both equations, there is no symmetry in general situation of general situation for alpha n and beta n. And we investigate this equal both equation in the article with Hyperboolean and Emilio. And we are able to prove not in this article and in the same article the following result. The first order symmetry in direction exists if and only if the function alpha n is a constant. And about the second order symmetry, the situation is following. The second order symmetry exists if exists a second order symmetry, then alpha n is a two-periodic function. And if alpha n is two-periodic function with and this function is not a constant, then exists a non-generate second order symmetry. And now a symmetry of first order. I try to explain what it's happened in the language of Lux pair. If you look to Lux pair for both equation for greater n, we see that in both cases as stationary singular point depend on n. In H1 equation, stationary singular point look like alpha n, and for discrete Gressian chain, stationary singular point look like this. Both this equation doesn't have fixed stationary singular point. So we cannot use some formally generalization procedures for some other methods for finding consideration laws from Lux pairs. And for non-constant function alpha n. And what we can do for periodic function alpha n. if we consider periodic function alpha n, n capital periodic function, then we can go to the compound flux theory. Yeah. I change the operator in n direction. I make operator which contain shift for n capital times. For do this, I make this compound n matrices by production of n of these matrices. And after this, you can see that this operator have the singularity set like this. And now this singularity set doesn't depend on discrete variable n for H1 equation and doesn't depend for variable n for this discrete recent chain. And we can make formal generalization procedure and construct blocks generalized symmetries for blocks by conservation rules and make loose scattering transform. And we formulate hypothesis that equation 36 and 46 have a symmetry in any direction if and only if alpha n is a periodic function. And if alpha n has a period n, then the simplest generalized symmetry of these equations have the order n. These equations give us the examples when generalized symmetry in one direction can be can have any loop, any possible loss order. So if you want to get the equation with fifth order generalized symmetry, we need to put alpha n with period higher, and then we will be able to find generalized symmetry of order 5. Here I show generalized symmetry of order 2 for both equations. For example, for this H1 equation, this trigonometric function alpha n and zero beta n, we have this generalized symmetry in n direction. This generalized symmetry
equation H1 from the Radek-Babenko subspace.
I put when n is equal to 0. This is the periodic function on the
focus.
Yeah, it's this equation satisfies for PG consistency property, but if we look for post order generalized symmetry, we will find. We can find only a second order generalized symmetry like this. But this generalized symmetry contains not one generalized symmetry. It contains three generalized symmetry. The two of them is because Pn is arbitrary trigonometric function, and the third one is plays a role of matrix symmetry. So this situations appear sometimes for quadratic equations. And for this discrete chain, with two periodic function factor n, we are able to find this second order generalized symmetry. And here we see that it again contains three generalized symmetry. And two of them form periodic function beta n, and one correspond to massive symmetry. Like in previous example. And what we can see in this equation, this equation is non-autonomous, but we can find autonomous subcase when alpha n is periodic function, but special periodic function. If this periodic function look like this, beta is n capital in power of n, and if beta n is a primitive root of community, then this equation becomes autonomous. And in this case, situation with generalized symmetries remain the same. So if beta n capital is primitive root from the unity for particular beta 2 is equal to minus 1, beta 3 is equal to 1 of this, values beta 4 is equal to 1 of this, and for any other n capital, there exist at least two primitive root from unity, then for any of these equations, we can find a generalized symmetry of order n capital. And here I present the generalized symmetry for n capital equal to 3. It's depend on 7 shift from n minus 3 to n plus 3, because here n plus 2 and here one more shift operator. And in this case, this generalized symmetry contains 4 symmetries, because 2 of them, 3 of them, 1 of them is autonomous. It corresponds to B1. 2 of them is non-autonomous. And the last one plays a role of massive symmetry. In this article with Danilov, we show that this equation have autonomous Lux pair, like here, compound Lux pair autonomous. In this case, Lux pair is non-autonomous. And we show that in this case, the symmetry in n direction of order n capital is also autonomous, and we make hypothesis that generalized symmetry in n direction is order n capital is also autonomous in this case. But we prove this only n capital equal to 2, equal to 3. And here I show the exact reference. In first article, we find equation 6, our non-standard quad equation. In this article, we investigate this non-standard equation in details. Here we found non-autonomous similar examples. Here we investigate autonomous discrete equation on square lattice with these unusual properties. So this equation, and And these articles, which I am not discussing my talk, we find some modified series of autonomous discrete equation from this equation. So we find some non-point transformation from this equation and find more examples of such type. What I can say, that this equation 6 remain unique in a sense that it's Lagrange pair cannot be written as operator in one shift. So for any other direction, we have Lagrange pair with one shift operator. For this equation, Lagrange pair only in this form. And if exists equation with Lagrange pair by free shift or more shift, is I do not know answer to these questions. It possible exists, but possible no. How to find this equation, I do not know. This equation is fine as a we do not look for this type of equation. We look for more simple equation, but it was a happy case to find this equation. So I stop my talk. Thank you for attention. Thank you very much.
Are there any questions or comments? Okay, in which case, let's thank the speaker again. So we can have a break until 5:30.